So, hello everyone, my name is Lokesh Kumar Prajapati and I am assistant professor from Suresh Gyan Vihar University. So today we will discuss about the accommodation operation second service. So what is the meaning of second service? So we will describe in this session also. So we will just talk about the hotels, organizations, and we just talk about the guest also. We will talk about the equipments. We will talk about to the cleaning. We will talk about to the deep cleaning also, because what is the reason we have to provide to the good environment to the guest. Because of reason this when we will not provide to the good services for the guest, it means that they will not come back again, and we are just losing our to the profits also. So that's why we have to give it's a good environment and good things also over there. So why we do the cleaning, because of we just provide to the hygienic and safe and good environment related to the things also. Now let's talk about to the accommodation operation second service. Now introduction. So purpose of cleaning: to maintain a safe and clean environment. Second point is to preserve furniture and fitting in good conditions also. Now third one is to maintain an attractive environment. Now we are just looking that to maintain a safe and cleaning environment. So we just do that thing inside to the maintain and safe and clean environment for in environment in the organization, because we will not provide to the this kind of environment in the hotels to the guest. So it means that guest will not come back again. To preserve furniture and fitting in good conditions. To preserve furniture and fitting in good conditions. So we have to just keep the furniture in a good conditions also. We have to just put and do the fitting in a good conditions. We have to just keep always neat and clean, because what is the reason whenever just guest come in the hotel and just look it to the first look it to the sitting area, because when we'll not clean to the sitting area, sofa will be dirty also. It means that if guest allergetic from dust, and we will not clean to the dust, and we will not do clean to the furniture every day, we will not remove to the dust, it means that guest will be energetic allergic that time also. So that's why we have to the clean furniture and fitting in good condition also. Now third one is maintaining attractive environment. Now we have to the maintain attractive environment means when the guest come inside to the hotel, it means we are provide to the good things also, and we give to the special things we need to do that time also. So we have to the maintain our lobby also. We have to the maintain our garden also. We have to check out to the corridors also. We have to the provide flower arrangement inside to the lobby also. We have to just arrange to the lots of things. So that's why we have to do that kind of thing, because of the guest we can make to the attractive environment for the guest. When we'll make to the attractive environment in a hotel industry, so in an organization or maybe in a premises, so means that a guest can stay over there for a long time also, and he will come back again and again, because what is the reason he loves it that place, and he wants to spend our time. It's a personal own time, and maybe that time he can spend as a coffee timing also. So that's why we have to do that things. So we have to just maintain to the attractive environment. So that's why always hotel's lobby always be very attractive, because of the that place is a very good And because that place just can see that place is just like a wow, because what is the reason they do the flower arrangement also, and deep and clean also, because floor also will be always be shining. So that's why we have to check out everything, because what is the reason everyone's like to the neat and clean and hygiene place also. So that's why this is introduction and purpose of cleaning, to maintain safe and cleaning environment. Second one is to preserve furniture and fitting in good condition also. Now third one is to maintain attractive environment. Now good cleaning organization may leads to, first point is appearance, create favorable impression and indication of the operational efficiency of staff. Now we just see that two guys is cleaning in the inside to the in on the lobby. So appearance create favorable impression and indication of the operational efficiency of staff. So we have to provide good equipment to the provide to the staff, because what is the reason we can just take out of the good efficiency and good work come out from the staff. They can do a very in a much conditions, because they are just losing less of energies, losing less of energies with related to work, and when can use to the lots of places. Because what is the reason, if we will not provide to the good equipment for the staff, it means that they can lose all energies at a same place, and we cannot use to them to another place, because what is the reason they are already tired. So that place that another place cannot do the good cleaning that type that place also. So that's why we have to just create favorable impression and indication of the operational efficiency of the staff. Now next point is hygiene, create pleasant and hygienic environment. Now we just see that hygiene create pleasant and hygienic environment also. So we have to just create a pleasant and hygienic environment, because of the we will not create this kind of things, we will not provide to the hygienic place for the guest, so guest will not come back again, because he just make a one memories, or maybe he can just make a mind also, because that place is dirty. So I will not go over there, because I will be whenever I just go over there, because that place is very dirty. I found that place very dirty, and my health is going to the worst. So that's why we have to the just going to the create place and hygienic environment also, because if we will provide to the hygienic place to the guest, it means that he will feel better. He can spend lots of time over inside to the hotels also, and he can just he can come back again and again, and he give to the good business also, and he just recommend it to the another person also. So that's why we have to just provide good pleasant, create pleasant and hygienic environment. Now third one is plant maintenance, so prolong and working life of furnishing and equipment. So plant maintenance prolong the working life of furnishing and equipment. So now this the good cleaning organization may leads to appearance, create favorable impression and indication of the operational efficiency of staff. Now second point is hygiene, create pleasant and hygienic environment also. Now third one is planned maintenance and prolong the working life of furnishing and equipment. Now types of soil. So organic, plant or animal, human origin or compound, solid, liquid and gas substance. Now we can see that types of soil, which kind of soil we can provide and we can get inside to the organization. So plant or animal we can just put over there, and human origin or compounds also, solid, liquid, gases and substance also. Now second point is inorganic, chemical elements or compound, solid, liquid or gases, substance also. Now third one is osmological, either organic and inorganic that emit an unpleasant odor also, Now next one is bacterial, live bacterial or spores may cause diseases or infections. Now third one, next last one is, so entomological, insects of pest so carries disease or infection also. Now we just see that organic, plant or animal, human origin or compound, solid, liquid, and gaseous substances also. Now second one is inorganic, chemical elements or compound, solid, liquid, or gaseous substances. Now third one is osmological, either organic or inorganic, that emit a unpleasant odor also. Now next one is bacterial, live bacterias or spores may cause diseases or infections. Now next point is entomological, insects or pests carries disease or infection also. So these types of soils we can found inside to the hotel industry and kitchen also. Now we can see that inside to the that kind of things just make to the unhygienic place inside to the organization. So we can just see that inside to the room we will get this kind of things, hair with the hair on the floors. So that things also not good inside to the hotel room, because what is the reason we have to the clean that thing, because that thing we will keep on the carpet, it means that will stick. So that's why we have to the clean that things also. Now second picture just described to us soup or maybe some drinks also will fell down also over there. So that's why we have to the clean, because it's a very dangerous, because what is the reason, if this place is a public area, so we have to the just put a caution board and we have to the clean immediately, because what is the reason we will not clean that. So means any guest come over there, and if it will not see this kind of things, so it will fell down also, it can get to the injuries also, and he can claim to the organization also. So that's why we have to the clean that things also, and that thing we will not clean, it means that it will dry, or maybe it will be just odor will come out to the odor, and things also, bad things also come related to these things also. Now we can see this cockroach is the main thing, so we have to do a pest control, because what is the reason we will not do the pest control, it means that cockroach and cockroach babies come inside to the in room, and they can just disturb to the guest also, and they just spread to the unhygienic place also, because that animal is spreading to the unhygienic things also, because this is a very dangerous for the human bodies also, because what is the reason it just bring to the lots of enzymes, and so that's why we can we cannot see in a proper, because that time, because in a night time they come outside and then come to the all of things, because if he will feel we cannot see this, and he just eat our food also, it means that our food is contaminated, because that animal just look at to the all of because eat lots of things, so that's why we cannot eat that food also, because he already ate, so that's why our food contaminated, so we have to just throw it. Now third picture is cat is people just carry on the cat also, so we have to the another place for the keep to the pets, because pets not allowed to the organization, and we when just allowed to the pets, so we have to the keep inside to the cage for another room. So we cannot allow to the cat inside to the room, because what is the reason we will allow to the cat inside to the room, it means that it will be lots of things, because a cat's hair can come on to the beds, and some people's hair is too much allergic related to animals' hairs also, they can just smelly also, have a different odor also. So that's why we cannot allow to the cat inside to the organization. Now nature of soil, organic, loose, dry, usually referred to do as dust, it can generally be removed with direct chemical mechanical act. As long as it stays dry, it can be swept, dusted, mopped, wiped, vacuumed, or wet mopped with minimal or no chemical action required. Any surfaces that has not been cleaned in 12 hours will have dust gathered on it. The longer it remains on a surface, a better chance it has to be becoming oily, sticky, oil form stained with other substance, even from moisture in the air or from air conditioning units also. Now, second point is inorganic, oily, sticky, soil or dirt is about always mixed with grease or other oily resources, which makes the dirt glue to the tree surface. The extent to which dirt remain on a surface with the more happen with the bone to the surface, and the harder it's to the get rid of. Now we can just see that nature of soils: organic, loose, dry, usually referred to as dust. It can generally be removed with direct mechanical act. As long as it stay dry, it can be swept, dusted, mopped, wiped, and vacuum or wiped out also, with minimal or no chemicals action required. Any surfaces that has not been cleaned in 12 hours will have dust gathered on it. The longer it remains on a surface, the better chance if it has of becoming oily, sticky, soil form stained with other substance, even from moisture in the air or from air conditioning units also. Now, second one is inorganic, oily, sticky, oily or dirt is about to the always mixed with grease or other oily resources, which make the dirt glue and the surface. The extended to which dirt remains on the surface, the more it happens on to bond to the surface, and the harder it is to get rid of. Standards of cleaning. The first point is physically clean, free from apparent dust and dirt when wiped by hand. Now, second one is chemically clean, free from harmful chemical on surface and in the surrounding air. Now, bacteriological clean, free from any harmful bacteria that may cause disease and infection also. Now, next point is entomological clean, free from harmful insects or pests. Now, osmological clean, free from any organic and inorganic soils. Next point is, so terminally clean surface needs to be consistently sanitized. Now we can just see that the physically clean, free from apparent dust and dirt when wiped by hands. So chemically clean, free from harmful chemical on surface and in the surrounding air. So bacteriological clean, free from any harmful bacteria that may be that may cause disease or infection also. Entomological clean, free from harmful insects or pest also. So osmological clean, free from any organic and inorganic soil also. So terminally clean surface needs to be consistently sanitized. So these are the standards of cleaning. So guest room cleaning process. Housekeeping have serviced between 13 to 18 bedrooms in a day. So housekeeping department just clean to the 13 to 18 bedrooms in a day, because what is the reason? Have inside to the hotels have a lots of rooms. So so one person just clean to the 13 to 18 bedrooms in a day in a shifting times. Not take more than 30 minutes to accomplish service one room. So we just get an assignment. We 30 minutes only just accomplish a service a room, because we just can spend, we can take 30 minutes for one room, because of the reason, because we have another room also, or maybe 10 to 20 rooms also. So that's why we have to just provide to them to another ones also, because according to standard, according to SOPs, so we just accord SOPs. So it's 30 minutes or maybe 20 minutes, it's just enough for the one room accomplished service or one accomplished to the room service. Now, third point is inform floor supervisor that that prepared guest room can be inspected. Now we can see that inform floor supervisor that prepared guest room can be inspected. When we clean to the room, when we can make to the room and we just prepare to the guest room, so we have to just call to the supervisor for inspected, because supervisor will give to the green sheet because of the he just satisfied room is clean or not, have just something left, because we I am employees, so because supervisor have a duty, so he just will come and inspect and he sorry inform all supervisor that prepared guest room can be inspected. So priority for cleaning room that guest has request early service VIP rooms before 11 a.m. Now we are just looking that priority for cleaning rooms. So this topic is a priority of cleaning rooms. So which kind of rooms we have to the give priority for the room cleaning, because so now we will discuss about this thing. First point is room that guest has requested early service VIP rooms before 11 a.m. So early morning checkouts requested by front desk, other checkouts. Now next point is occupied rooms with please make my rooms sign on doorknob. Now next point is room that has D&D card display early in the morning. Next point is requested request for late service 4 to 5 p.m. Now we can see that the room that guest has request early service VIP rooms before 11 a.m. Now second is early morning checkouts requested by front desk, other checkouts VD rooms also. Now occupied rooms with please make my room sign on the doorknob also. So room that has made D&D card displayed early in the morning. So request for all late service 4 to 5 p.m. So now we just when we see to the D&D card display early in the morning, so we will not touch that the room when call to the guest in we just inform to the front office for cleaning time, we just inform to the, because that's guest outside is D&D or so we will not just door we will just knock the door, we will not knock the door, because what is the reason guest may be inside sleeping or he is busy with the very important meeting. So that's why we will not disturb to the guest, and we just left that the guest, and after the guest will finish the meeting also, maybe he woke up late also and he will call to the us. So when I just on the shift, so I will ask to the guest, sir, may I clean your room, because that morning time your outside the guest is D&D. So that's why we have to do that things also. So room that guest has requested early service VIP room, because if VIP guest coming inside to the hotel, so we have to the clean before early morning, before 8 a.m. we have to the clean that things also, because what is the reason is a check-in time is at 12 a.m. so that's why we have to the clean, as we have to just ready before 11 a.m. because we are just providing to the VIP service to the VIP guest. So early morning checkout requested by front desk, other checkouts also. Occupied rooms with please make my room sign in on doorknob. If guest just put inside, because guest don't have a time, he cannot stay inside the room when housekeeping staff will come over there and just finishing. So guest just put on the signage on doorknob, please make my room, clean my room. So guest hotel staff will come over there, he will just take a key also, another dummy keys on the floor one. So firstly he just knock the door and he will ask about to the housekeeping, just inform to the identification or Then housekeeping. If nobody wants, just give to the answer inside to the room. Then he can go and just check out to the one more time and just announce to the housekeeping for identification which staff is coming is inside. Maybe guest inside and taking bath or maybe sleeping. So that's why we have to just announcing ID also. If we will not find to the guest inside and guest luggage is over there, so we will not touch to the guest luggage and allow all of things. So we will make to the guest room. We will change to the bed sheet also. We just change to the amenities also. We will refill to the amenities and we will refill to the supplies also. We change to the towels and hand towels also. We clean to the bathrooms and windows also. We just give to the put inside to the amenities also. So that things we have to do. So that things room that has D&D card display early in the morning, request for late service 4 to 5 p.m. also. Now dealing with D&D rooms. So what is the procedure when we find to the D&D doorknob on the outside to the room? So first one is, so now we just discussing about to the dealing with the D&D rooms. So first point is, procedure should be set up for dealing with rooms with D&D sign is after 2:30 p.m. and room attendant will inform the supervisor. Then supervisor will check the room status with front desk by phone or in person also. Usually the D&D slip will be placed under the door to inform the guest and their room is not serviced yet. In most cases, room attendant should not knock on a door with the D&D sign. Now we just see that procedure should be set up the dealing with rooms with D&D signs is after 2:30 p.m. Room attendant will inform the supervisor. Then supervisor will check the room status with front desk by phone or in person. Usually the D&D slip will be placed under the door, inform the guest that their room is not serviced yet. Now fourth point is, in most cases room attendant should not knock on the door with D&D. When we'll get the D&D on the doorknob, so we will inform to the supervisor, because that time is maybe in the afternoon also, we will just find is a 2:30 p.m. or maybe 3 p.m. we will find to the D&D early till to morning also, or still get to the 2:30 p.m. also. So that's why we have to just inform to the supervisor, because this is our duty, because not cleaning yet the cleaning that time also. So that's housekeeping supervisor will go to the front office and he will just inform to the duty manager, and duty manager will call inside to the room and he will get the status and he check to the status on the desktop also, and they call to the person who's stay inside to the guest. So because we have a lots of reason, maybe guest infant inside to the room, maybe have some accident inside to the room with the guest also, maybe that guest belongs to the very terrorist activity. So that's why we have to just see to the all the guests. Now preparing to clean. The room attendant work day begins in the linen, the room headquarters of the employees reports to work. Second one is receive room assigning HK housekeeping department room status reports and keys also. Third one is the room attendant prepare for the work days, assembles the organize the supplies necessary for cleaning, check out the ends of his her shift. Now the room attendant work day begins in the linen room headquarters of the employees report to work, receives from assigned room status reports and keys. The room attendant prepare for the work day, assemble and organize the supplies necessary for cleaning, check out at the ends of his or shift also. So this is the room attendant work day begins in the linen room headquarters to the housekeeping department. Now assembling supplies. The room attendant requires special tools, example, cleaning supplies and equipment in the room, accessories and amenities to prepare a guest room. The room attendant cart is regarded as a toolbox stocked with everything necessary to do an active job for a half day or unable to the guest room attendant to avoid wasting time blocking for a cleaning time and or supplies also. Now we just see that assembling supplies. Now we can see the maid cart only once more again here. A room attendant requires special tools, example, cleaning supplies and equipment, linen, room accessories and amenities to prepare a guest room. Now next point is the room attendant cart. Is regarded as a toolbox stocked with everything necessary to do an effective job for a half day to enable the guest room attendant to avoid wasting time and looking for a cleaning time items or supplies also. Now stocking the cart. Most room attendant cart have a shelf, the lower of three linens and the top of the supplies. Avoid over the understocking. Item found on the cart includes. First one is clean sheets, pillowcases and mattresses, pads also. Now next one is clean bath mats. Next is toilet and facial tissues also. Next one is fresh drinking glasses. Next one is soap bars. Next is cleaning ashtrays and matches also. Now we just see that is stocking the cart, which kind of things we have to keep inside to the maid cart trolley. So we can discuss about here. The most room attendant carts have four shelves, because carts have four shelves, so we have to just keep to the every shelves have every specialties. The lower three, four linen, the lower three, four shelf for the linen and the top for the supplies. Avoid over the understocking. Item found on the cart includes. Now, first point is clean sheets and pillowcases and mattress pads also. So, clean bath mats, toilet and facial tissues. Next is fresh drinking glasses, soap bars and clean ashtray and match boxes. Now we can just see that this is a maid cart trolley. So component trolley cart, room attendant trolley cart. So first one is gadget, amenities, sanitaries rack also. Second one is the garbage hampers. Third one is linen hampers. Fourth one is trolley rack. And fifth one is wheels. Now hand caddy, a kind of box is carried to the cleaning supplies for the guest room and bathrooms. May include, first one is glass cleaner, second one is floor cleaner, third one is wood polisher, next is a multi-purpose cleaner also, next toilet bowl cleaners, next air freshener, next is insect sprayer, next is ball brushes also, next is cloth and sponges also, next is rubber gloves also. A laundry bag for dirty and vacuum are also positioned on the cart also. Now room assignments. Prepared by supervisor, done manually in the room assignment logbook. The assignments sheets includes the name of the attendant, the whom the room is assigned, a list of room numbers assigned to each room attendant or any special instruction to any rooms. The room status reports or the housekeeping reports also provide information on the occupancy or coordination of the hotel's room on a daily basis. Use simple codes to indicate room status. Now we can just see that task sheet status, room status. This is summary all properties. The summarized by occupancy status. This is the occupancy status. So cleaning the guest room, entering guest room, knock the guest room door 3 times using the chuckless ring, the adorable, and the announce. Announce yourself. Observe whether the guest placed D&D sign on the doorknob. If D&D has been on the door after 2 p.m., inform supervisors. If no answer, insert key card and open door slightly. Proceed with room cleaning. If it is the clean double, and quietly close back. When entering the room, enter slowly with the caution. Listen for the clues. Such as a slower running, or a hairdresser, dryer, as these things can prevent your knock room being heard. If something is heard, immediately but slowly close the door and attempt knocking again. If entry must be made at that time, if not, wait a few minutes to return. If the guest is asleep or in the bathroom, quietly close and leave the room. Now, next point is leave the door, open the place, service card blocking the entrance for security purpose. The next point is reason for knocking guest room before entering to protect privacy of the guest to prevent embarrassment of employees. Now, cleaning of the guest room. Prepare for the room and cleaning by first point is turn off the lights. Second one is draw back curtains and check the cords and hooks for the damages also. Now, third one is open the windows and air the rooms also. Next is check the air condition and heaters. Now, next is take a good look at the room. Check the damage and missing items. Replace dirty ashtray and glasses. Next is collect any room service trays, empty waste basket in occupied rooms, and straight newspaper and magazines also in checkout rooms, and check for lost property also. Now, procedures. Now, strip the bed, removing bed sheets on a one of the ensure no lost and not found and found item and left behind the guest. Place everything on the floors. Now, second one is smoothen the mattress protector. Change mattresses protector if it is stained. Next is put on the first bed sheet right side up with the center fold as a guide. Tuck in top. Side and bottom side of bed and miter corners also. First point is pick up the edge of bed sheets about 10 upsides of bed. Tuck in the corner of sheets. Third one is drop the sheet down and tuck in sheets to form a miter fold also. Put second bed sheets with the wrong sides up and pull up sheets to reach the edge of mattress at the head. Do not tuck in yet. Fifth one is put duvet blanket on the bed with the top about 4 to 5 below edge of mattresses at the head. Sixth one is put third bed sheet with the top reach 3 below edge of mattress and the head. Fold into the third sheet top under blanket. Fold over second sheet also. Fold down sheets and blankets about 6 with rooms also below also. So go to the foot of the bed at the sides, tuck in the blanket and the bed sheets also together at one or go and the miter corner at both sides neatly. Put pillowcases on pillows. Position pillows even on bed with the open hands away from the guest sides door if possible. Smoothen bed with your palm. Now, tips in the bed making videos. Now, tips on the bed making in a hotel step by step. Cleaning the guest room. Process the clean the guest room. Brush. So, first point is brush lamp shades with a dry cloth and feather duster also. Second one is spray doors, furniture and fixtures with cleaning solution and damp wipe and with dust cloth also. So, third one is wipe air. Vents, windows, sills, light bulbs, telephones, and others surface with a damp cloth, wipe out drawers, clean or replace all recycled items, spray mirrors and TV screens, wipe with the dry glasses cloth, center all traps, lamp shades and pictures also. Now third one is, if the room have balcony, does have a furniture and sweep the floor also. Now cleaning of the guest room, wiping the dusting. Next point is replenishing room amenities and guest supplies. Next one is wash glasses, ashtray and trays also. So cleaning the bathroom. Now next point is cleaning the toilet bowl. Second point is cleaning the bath tub and shower rooms also. Third one is scrub bathroom floors. Fourth one is clean sink, counter and mirrors. Next one is replenishing bath, linen and bathroom supplies and amenities. Now next point is vacuum the carpets. Now 10th point is spray air fresheners. Cleaning the guest room. So final check. First point is take a look at the room for the guests respectives. Start at the point in the room and look in the circular fashion also. Second point is smell the room from any unusual odors also. Third one is close the door, check that it's locked. And next is update the status of the room on the assignment sheets. Turning mattress. Simple mattress task increase working life mattress. Next is each mattress is turned 4 times in a year, one completed in its rotation annually. Next point is for a long and life and durability the mattresses. Next is should be cleaned with vacuum. Next is a mattress inspection, floor supervisors. So second service, special request by the guest after the guest room has already been serviced early in the day, chargeable service, held visitors meeting, parties and procedures. First one is remove empty bottles and dirty glasses. Second is empty and clean ashtray, dust, paper, basket. Third one is a replenishing and used guest supplies. Fourth one is arrange furniture in its proper place. Fifth one is vacuum carpet. Wipe all dirty spots on the table or other surfaces also. So replace solid towels, clean and sink and towel bowl if dirty. Wipe the bathroom floor if wet. So decoration is requested by the guest. Now turn down service. So refers to the practice of staff entering a guest room and turn down service and bad linen and bad in the rooms to preparing for the bad use. The purpose is ensure the guest feels the home at can instantly to bad. Upon returning on his or her room, always carry it out between 5 to 9 p.m. just before the guest return from the nights. And the item of confectionery, such as a chocolate or a mint, is typically left on the top of pillow in the bed and that has been turned down service. Now, item requires housekeeping trolley cart, towel linens, amenities, cleaning caddy, amenities, agents, materials, and complimentary products, chocolates, mints, and others also. Now procedure, turn down service, the even staff takes status reports of the floor from the front desk. Now take the floor key, card and sign for it. Take a round of the floor corridor to the maintenance clean and tidy. Take the trolley, take out trolley departure. Departure room have to the clear as per the requirements. Find out the if the guest if not in the room, announce yourself before entering the guest room. In case the guest wants to you come back later, then politely then as the time for the position it may start in front of the guest room. Turn down bed. Enter the room, empty dustbin and ashtray also. Remove the bed covers, fold in place in the luggage rack or drawer. Next one is remove pillow from luggage rack and place it on the head of the bed. Make 90 angles with the second sheets quality and third sheets. Spread the foot mat on the side on the bed and the foot slipper on the top on the foot mat. So always give turn down from the telephone sides or inner sides of the bed. For double occupancy, both corner to be mat. Replace solid linen and when needed. So according to the hotel procedure, place the turn down amenities on the bed. Place the breakfast menus doorknob on the fold. Put on the bedside lamp also. So look around the room straight on the tidy anything that is the outer of the order. So if any room messy is may require more extensive cleaning, dusting and so remove any room service tray dishes and remove them service pantries also. Empty the trash can the replace the waste basket linen, so do any quick vacuum if required. So neatly found, fold, use towels, wipe the vanity areas required. If required, replace the bathing towels, clean the dustbin if used. Fold toilet papers and replace if necessary, replace bathroom amenities as needed. Now we can just see turn on the bed side lamps, close the drapes, draw the curtain so that there is no lights coming from the corners or centers. Set the AC temperature on the wall set by the guest. Double check everything, lock the room and the leave the guest room. Update the status report also. Now closing down, important is preparing to clean the equipment, agents and other supplies should be stored properly. Work area should neat and tidy for next shift also. Now lost and found. So when the items are found in the must be taken to the housekeeping department and adequately tagged, logged in the identification, the lost and found must include also the date on the which of the item was found, item description, that person who found it, the numbers of assigned the tag items, items containing multiple articles should be in inventoried, the content described and verified to person, all tag item must be kept under the lock and security person, all inquiry inquiries regarding lost and found items should be addressed to the housekeeping office. Item not claimed within the reasonable period of time are given to the employees who found or given away the charitable organization. Which is the item, so valuable item, expensive in circumstances of amount, housekeeping personnel will handle this missing items, handle case under housekeeping law. Now next one is the non-valuable item, the small amount, HK attendant should record it down the item, missing item report or logbook. Now we have MCQs also. So first question is, part of the receptionist duty is the screen, phones, calls. The reason for this is to. Now next question is, a receptionist should have a good memories and name and face so they can remember. Now next question is, SOP stands for. Next question is, which of the following is not the type of folio, a master folio. Next question is, who takes care complaint handling. Next question is, in a large full service hotel, the front office manager reports to the. The next question is, the L. Berry, B. Jethmal models measure service quality is known as what. So next question is, in what century were hotels as we known that today developed. Next question is, which of the following provides the best proof is identified when a traveler check from a foreign guest. Which of the term to the design system where the guests serve them also. So this topic we have to end here. So now next topic we will talk about to the different topics for today. Thank you.